Hey everybody, in this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you how to write a proper email, and we're going to be using Gmail. So I'm here on the Google homepage, and you'll notice right here that it says Gmail. That's one way I could get to my email. Another way I can get to Gmail is by clicking on the Google apps here, and you can go here to Gmail. You might also want to add Gmail as a bookmark. So the way you would do that is by going up here and bookmarking this tab. And then if you don't want that to have all of that, you can take that off so that it just says Gmail. So the benefit of adding Gmail as a bookmark is that you'll be able to get back there very quickly. So if you're back here on Google and you want to get to your Gmail, you can get to Gmail. Similarly, if you're on another web page altogether, rather than trying to retype in Gmail or go back to Google and get the Gmail app, all you have to do is click on that bookmark. Okay, we're in Gmail and we need to compose an email. So the way that we're going to do that is by going here to compose, and that's going to pop up a little box for you that will allow you to type an email. In the to section of the email, you are going to type the email address of a person that you want to send the email to. And then in the subject line, you're going to write the subject of your email. This is the first place where I start to see students making some mistakes. So one mistake that I see is that students simply do not have a subject. And another mistake that I see is that students try to write an entire sentence in their subject. So you don't want to leave it blank, but you also don't want to fill it up with a ton of information. The best guideline is to keep your email subject relatively short. So for example, if this email is going to be about needing additional support, you could write "need additional support." Or if the email is going to be about a question that you have, you could just write "a question." If you want to let your teacher know that you will not be in class tomorrow, rather than a complete sentence, you could write "absent tomorrow." So notice that all you're doing here is writing a few words that tells the person who's getting your email what the content of your email is going to be about. Notice as well that I am not putting everything in all caps, and I'm also not capitalizing the first letter of the second word because it's not a proper noun. So we just write "absent tomorrow" with a lowercase t. Then in the first line of your email, you're going to need to address your teacher. The most proper way to do that is by saying "dear" and then writing your teacher's name. Mr., we'll call our teacher J. After Mr. J, you want to put a comma, and then you're going to hit the return key twice. Then you'll start the content of your email. After you've written your email with correct punctuation and capitalization, you're going to hit the return key twice again, and you are going to sign off on your email. So you can say things like "thanks," or if you want to make it more formal, you can say something like "sincerely." Another way you could sign off an email is with "best." There are a couple of other important things to show you about emailing. Now, let's say that you want to actually send this email to multiple teachers to let them know that you're going to be absent. You could go up here to the recipient section of the email and then type your other teacher's email address. If you do that, you're also going to want to change the salutation. So instead of just saying "Mr. J," you would want to say "Dear Mr. J" and "Mr. Teacher." Something else you might want to do is attach things to your email. So for example, if there was something from your computer that you needed to attach, you could go down here to "Attach Files," and that will allow you to select files from your computer that you could add to your email. And then when you are ready to hit send on that email, you're going to go down to the blue send button and hit send. All right, those are the very basics of how to create an email in Gmail. And look out for another tutorial where we're going to go over some of the different attachments that you can add to your email as well.